A very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to Sports Tonight. This is the midweek edition of the show. It's the Wednesday night. We're here to do what we love to do, which is to take you on a cruise around the exciting world of sports. And tonight is not going to be any different. We'll be taking you across the globe. We will, of course, at some point, take you to Gabon, where the 2017 Africa Cup of Nations final group games are going on. In Group D, Ghana against Egypt. The Egyptians are up by a goal at halftime, and then Uganda against Mali. We'll talk extensively about the Africa Cup of Nations on the program tonight. We will also, on this edition of the show, spend quality time to review match day 4 of the Nigeria Professional Football League and tell you about the results of games played across different centers in Nigeria. This evening, I can tell you that today we had 4 games ending goalless, and I think it's a reflection of the fact that our teams are becoming so well prepared, so equally matched, that there is little to separate them, whether they're playing at home or away. So we'll talk about it as well on the program tonight. On Sports Tonight as well, we will be talking tennis. We'll be taking you to Melbourne, Australia, and we'll be focusing on the first Grand Slam of the year, Australia Open, down now to the business end. And we'll be giving you all the lowdown, all the updates, what you want to know, what you want to see. We will be serving you on the program tonight, all right? So you are in for a swell time, and together, I can assure you, we will make it worth your while. But let me just quickly start off the show tonight by inviting you to be a part of all that we're doing on the program tonight. Tell you what you can do to be a part of the show. Our show is not a monologue. We are not the ones that will do the talking from this side. We want to hear from you. You are very central. You are very key to all that we'll be doing on the program tonight, and that's by means of feedback. All right? So we expect you to take advantage of our platforms for feedback on the program tonight, on Facebook and on Twitter. Those social media tools are going to be available for you to interact with us on the program tonight. And you can see on Facebook our channels, iPhone Sports, and of course the other handles on Twitter are also going to be there to support the Facebook so that we can have an engagement with you on many platforms. All right, so we expect you to take advantage of that on the program tonight. Let me also tell you very quickly that you can keep track of all that we're doing on Channels TV, not just on our sports shows, on everything that goes on your award-winning Channels television, on our website, www.channelstv.com, as well as on youtube.com/channelsweb. All right? So get ready to enjoy all of it. You could also click on m.channelstv.com if you want to view us on your BlackBerry, your iPhone, your iPad. You want to connect to your home for the news. That's all you need to do. It's as simple as ABC. You can go a step further and download the Channels app for Windows, iOS, Android from their respective stores. It takes you where we want you to be. Channels at your fingertips, all right? And then you also are very close to Channels. You can enjoy all the package, all the news, all the sports, entertainment, health, 24/7 at all the time. All right. So, and as you do all of this, we always like to encourage you to tell us where your posts, your comments, your tweets are coming from, so that we can appreciate you a lot more on Sports Tonight. All right. So that's the much for the feedback. We also want you to engage with us around the games of the 2017 Africa Cup of Nations. Yesterday, you saw the defending champions Cote d'Ivoire crash out from the group phase. All right? So there's a lot of drama around the Nations Cup. So talk to us about it. Who do you feel will be having the last laugh at this competition? It's becoming very, very unpredictable. At the beginning of the tournament, experts told us that this is one competition that will be too close to call. And I think it is living up to that hype, all right? So, but you can tell us who you feel will be going all the way to becoming champions of Africa. We're going to be having new champions now because the Elephants of Cote d'Ivoire will not be defending that title. All right. So that's the much for interaction, for feedback. Let me quickly introduce Austin Okonapan, who is joining me for the first half of Sports Tonight this midweek. And just start off immediately by asking what you feel. The defending champions are not going to be there for the AFCON. It's like a tradition.
That's right.
And earlier on, a few minutes ago, Yemi Adebayo was ruling out to me the long list of defending champions who couldn't make it beyond the group phase in the preceding competition. And some of them didn't even qualify at all.
I was hoping you were going to mention, that. I was going to help you. So it's good to be
some
here.
Some didn't qualify three editions in a row.
I know.
Some didn't qualify two
what a
in
story.
A row.
It's good to be here. Good to be at Sports Tonight. Good to have another opportunity to talk sports. What a tournament we're having in Gabon, you know. Who would ever think that after proceedings that you have DR Congo top that group from the group? You will never,
Cote d'Ivoire,
you know,
and Morocco.
Morocco, you know, you would never even think that Cote d'Ivoire will crash out of the competition with just 2 points without a victory. So we're having a fantastic time with African football. It tells you, Tony, that no team is small anymore. That teams are seeing the need to get better. And that's why we have defending champions come, and then the next edition, they make them look like they didn't even win at all. So, was I surprised? Yes, because it's Cote d'Ivoire. We expected so much from them, you know. But, I mean, this is football. Anything can happen. I'm so excited it's happening in Africa. And for us in this part of the world, our team is not playing. It's another reminder that when the qualifiers start, no small team. And when you eventually make it in 2019, because Tony, we're just talking, I'm saying, take out Zimbabwe from that group and put the Super Eagles there. It might just be too tough for us. Take off Togo and put the Super Eagles in that DR Congo, Morocco, and Cote d'Ivoire. It's still tough.
Tough,
you know.
Group.
So, Tony, it's African football. It's developing.
Okay, so that's it. We want you to talk to us. What you feel about the ongoing Africa Cup of Nations. Who are you going to be putting your money on to go all the way? But let's come back now and take you quickly to this interesting story. And it's about the greatest athlete of all time in a lot of people's reckoning. They called it the triple-triple. But it's not going to be triple-triple anymore because, Austin, the story is that Usain Bolt may be losing one of the 9 gold medals that he has. And that's because of what his teammate Nesta Carter did in 2008, eight years ago.
What the IOC, WADA, and every agency that is a part of anti-doping they're trying to do is escape us this year. We're waiting for you 10 years from now. Escape us at the London 2012. You will meet us at Tokyo 2020. And again, since this is the relay, it's a team sport, it reminds you to tell your teammate, I hope you're clean. Because we don't want to get gold and then 7 years from now, because this is an embarrassment on Usain Bolt. We know the sort of respect he commands worldwide. Yes, he's not the one that is in the picture, but he's going to lose one Olympic gold medal. He had 9, now he's 8.
And he doesn't know what's ahead. A few years down the line, if another guy is found to have done something.
At London 2012, one more drop, you know.
You know?
And so now he's calling his teammates and he's saying, please, who is guilty next? So
tell me ahead of time, let me know.
You know, Tony, this is heartwarming. I like this, you know. And each time they pick up samples, the IOC, WADA, you know, they're trying to tell athletes, look, we are not done. You might beat us because of your masking agents or whatever techniques you use, but they are trying to tell us that the fight towards ensuring a clean sporting environment is an everlasting one. So they will continue to fish out these guys until we have a clean sport.
But there's some good news for us from all of this. We've benefited a lot from those who have been cheating. We have become an Olympic gold. We've won Olympic gold in the 4x4 Sydney. Because some of the Americans also did that. But it's an interesting one for Blessing Okagbare of Nigeria. She won bronze at the Beijing Games in 2008. But it's now going to be upgraded to silver.
That's right.
Because Russia's Tatiana Lebedeva also was found. That's the lady on your screen.
Yep.
Was also found to have done something.
Mm. And the Nigerian in me is saying, let them go and test the lady that won gold again. Just in case Okagwa would need to move up. Yeah, but Tony, is the same story for the men that is happening. It's a very good one for Blessing Okagwa. Remember, we have also gained, I think it's a Sydney Olympic team, Enefi Okudobong and his team, they moved up to get a gold medal. Really, really, really heartwarming, step that the IOC and all those involved are taking, and we need to support them too. We need to fish out whoever is not clean in the sport, because athletics have suffered a lot. Ask Russia, if they see Meldonium now, anything that is close to what WADA does not want, they don't just crush it, they'll put it to bottomless pits. And that's the sort of message, that's the watchdog program that the IOC they're trying to give. You can't come and cheat. Someone has been working for so many years for the Olympics that has a long-term program of 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years. And then you cheat, and then you come, you get a medal. Yes, the world will glorify you, but it's temporary, because when they fish you out now, it's embarrassing.
All right. So once again, it's coming a little late, but for Blessing, better late
Olympic
than never.
Silver medalist. Now
she's an Olympic silver medalist in long jump. But we still wait to see if by some luck she could still go one step up. But it's really very, very unfortunate for athletics that this is happening.